press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi students. So in the chapter surface areas and volumes, so we were discussing volume of cylinders. So far we have solved exercise 13.6 problems. 7 problems we have completed. So now I will take up the 8th one, exercise 13.6. Exercise 13.6, question number 8. So you can refer to your textbook, page 231, and read question number 8. A patient in a hospital is given soup daily in a cylindrical bowl of diameter 7 cm. So soup is served to the patient in a cylindrical cylinder. So cylindrical cylinder. Cylindrical cylinder. So that means it should be of this shape. It is a cylindrical cylinder. Now, if the bowl is filled with soup, so here it is given diameter D is equal to diameter of the cylinder 7 cm. Diameter is given, so therefore this dimension is given 7 cm. 7 cm. If the bowl is filled with soup to a height of 4 cm, so up to 4 cm height, this is the soup in this. Here this height is given 4 cm. 4 cm. So that is H is given is equal to 4 cm. How much soup the hospital has to prepare daily to serve 250 patients. So for 250 patients, how much soup required? The question is very simple. You have to calculate the volume of the soup in this bowl. In one bowl, you multiply it by 250. That's all. So here, answer you can proceed like this. Answer given diameter is equal to, that is D is equal to 7 cm. Therefore, radius will be D by 2. So radius will be 7 by 2 is equal to 3.5 cm. You calculate the radius. So now we have volume of soup in the cylinder in the cylinder is equal to, so this is, let us call this as V, volume is equal to, we have pi r square h, pi r square h. So students, in all these problems in surface area and volumes, whether it may be with respect to a sphere or a the circular cone or a right circular cylinder, whatever it is, wherever you come across pi, remember very clearly, if it is not given, if it is not given, better you always take it as 22/7. Sometimes it is given as 3.1, 3.14. So likewise, for 1 or 2 or 3, for 3 decimals, the value will be given in some of the problems. So what you have to do is, if the specifically value is given as 3.14, you have to take 3.14. If it is not given, take it as 22/7. So in this problem, pi value is not given, so I will take it as 22/7. So this is 22/7 and the radius is 3.5. So I will calculate 3.5 whole square into height is, you can see it is 4 centimeters. So this gives the volume of soap in one container. So it is 22/7 into 3.5 into 4. So this is, you simplify this, this is 22 into 3.5 into 3.5 into 4, you can write like this, divided by 7. If you simplify, this is 7 ones are 7.5 za, you will get cancel. So you are left with 22 into 0.5 into 3.5 into 4. If you multiply all these, you will get 154. 154 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of soap in one bowl. So such, it has to be served for 250 patients. So therefore total quantity of soup required for 250 patients. 250 patients is equal to 250 into 154. So 154. 250 into 154. So you will get 38,500. Centimeter cube. So now this is in centimeter cube. So if you divide it by 1000, because 1000 centimeter cube is equal to 1 liter, divide this by 38,500 divided by 1000, you will get liter. So this works out to be 38.5 liters. 5 liter. So to serve for 250 patients, the total quantity of soup required is 38.5 liters. So this completes exercise 13.7. 6. Now I will move on with 13.7. So that is the volume of right circular cone. I will erase this. Now the next topic is 13.8, volume of right circular cone. Section 13.8 in your textbook, it is volume of right circular cone. Volume of right circular cone. See, we know that for a right circular cylinder, just now we have completed one problem. So, for a right circular cylinder, the volume will be, so here it is the diameter and this is the height. If you take from the center, say from the center, this is out here. It is radius, and the volume will be, you are very familiar with this, pi r square h is the volume. See what happens if we have a right circular cone, let us say. That means a cone with the same radius as in this case. You observe here, it is like this. So, radius here and radius here are same, and I will join this like this. So, just like see, to put something, the ground nuts or any eatables, a paper cone will be made. So, likewise. So, here if the radius of this cylinder and this cone are same, let us say, or here and or here are same, or. Presume that it is a glass container. And if you fill water in it up to the brim and transfer it to the cylinder once, and second, see, as you can see, this is the volume is more and this is the volume is less. So second time if you fill, first when you put first time, it will cover up to 1/3 of the height, h/3. When you fill second time, it will come to the 2/3 of the height, up to here. So, up to here, for one time if you put water from here to here, second time it will come up to here, third time it will completely fill the cylinder. So, that means the volume of this cone is 1/3 of the volume of the cylinder, because if you put three times water from this to this, this will fill completely. So therefore we say volume of the right circular cone. Here there are two things. This is the central height, this is known as the height, and this is known as the slant height, slope area, and we represent it as L. And so this is RHL, so L becomes the hypotenuse, and therefore L square is equal to R square plus H square, using the Pythagoras theorem. I hope we are following this. So here we call this as, so this is when this is one time, and this will be filled with three times when we put the water. Therefore we say pi r square h divided by 3, pi r square h divided by 3. This is the volume of the right circular cone. So this is how we understand the volume of right. So one thing you have to bear in mind, the radius of the cylinder and the radius of the cone are same. If the radius is different, then we have to put the correct, because when these are to be equal, radius must be same. So volume of right circular cone, is equal to pi r square h by 3, pi r square h by 3. So this is how, using this formula, so given by V, let us say cone V is given by 4 pi r square h by 3. This formula we are going to use for solving the problems. So now I will take up example 15 from your textbook. Solved example 15. Example 15, the height and the slant height of a cone. So remember, where L is the slant height and H is the height. So L is called as slant height, H is height, R is of course radius, you are familiar with that. Height and slant height of a cone are 21 and 28 centimeter respectively. So height and slant height, the object given is right circular cone. Height is given, the height and slant height, height is 21 centimeter. Slant height L is given as 28 centimeter. Find the volume of the cone. See, now you observe the volume of the cone is given by the formula pi r square h by 3. So here R is not given, we have to calculate the R. So we have L square is equal to R square plus H square. So L is given, that is 28 square equals R square plus H square is 21 square. So this becomes 28 square minus 21 square. So for better convenience you put brackets here, 28 square 21 square. Now R will be equal to, or I will calculate R square is equal to 28 square and 21 square. You calculate 28 square. So 28 into 28. Now, so this is 784. So we will get 784, and 21 into 21 is 441. So that is 21 into 21. This is 21 and 42. You will get 441. Now R square equals, subtract this. 4 minus 1 is 3, and 8 minus 4 is 4, and 7 minus 4 is 343. So R square is 343. Now what is R then? Square root of 343. So R will be equal to, now 343, R will be equal to square root of 343. Let us try to factorize this 343. So it is like this. So 343, if you factorize, so to find the square root, so it is divisible by, say, 7. Seven fives are, it will not go. Seven fours are 28 plus 6. That means 4 6 9s are. You can see this. So you will get 343. That means 7 into 49 is 343, or 7 into 7 into 7. So let us factorize this instead of division. 343, it will be easy for you. 343, so 3, sorry, 7 4s are and 7 9s are. Now 7 7 7s are 7 1s are. So it is 7 cube. So root of 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. So I will write this as 7 equals, so this is square root of, I will take 7 square into 7, I will take it like this. Root of 7 square into root of 7, root of 7 square is 7, so therefore is equal to 7 into root 7. 7 into root 7, because square root of 7 square is 7. So this is how we have to simplify this. So this is only the R value. Now we have to calculate the volume. So volume of cone is equal to, so volume of cone, now we have calculated the radius, it was not given, we have calculated it. So pi r square h by 3, use this formula. Now we know the value of r, so this is 1 by 3 into this 1 by 3 into, or you can put it like this, pi is 22 by 7 into 22 by 7 into 1 by 3, you can put it in the beginning. So this is 1 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7 into r, we have calculated is 7 root 7. 7 root 7 whole square into height. Height is 21. Now you simplify this. This is 22 by 3 into 7 into 7 root 7 is 7 square into root 7 whole square. Root 7 whole square becomes 7 into 21. So this 7 and this 7 you can cancel. 3 7s are 21, you can cancel. So you are left with 22 into 7 square is 49 into 7. So this will be your answer. 22 into 49 to 7. 7, 5, 4, 6. 7, 5, 4, 6 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of the cylinder. So now I will move on to example 16. Students, I will erase this. So the formula we are using is volume of cone, right circular cone, of course volume equals pi r square h by 3. Remember this, all problems will be mostly on this formula only. Now the next question, 16th, Monica has a piece of canvas whose area is 551 meter square. So a paper is having, Monica is having a sheet of paper or a canvas area 551 centimeter square.
So the area is given. She uses it to have a conical tent made.
Meter square.
So she wanted to make it a conical tent made with a base radius of 7 meter.
See, using this canvas, she wanted to erect a tent of this kind, conical tent like this. It is something like this, tent.
And its radius is,
they are given, a tent will be of this kind. This is ground level, let us say. Now, here the radius given is from this circular bottom portion. This is radius is equal to 7 meter.
Radius of 7 meter.
So, R is equal to 7 meter.
Assuming that all the stitching margins and wastage incurred while cutting amounts to approximately 1 meter square. So, what they say here, assuming all the stitching and margin and wastage incurred while cutting the canvas amounts to approximately 1 meter square. Find the volume of the tent and that can be made with it. So here what is given is
canvas area is given as 1 meter square. So we have to deduct 551 we have to deduct 1 meter square because there is a 1 meter square wastage.
1 meter square wastage.
So, you observe this formula. Here volume is asked. Radius is given. So, actually volume is given, it is not given, area is given, area, that means curved surface area. So they have given the curved surface area. So in a right circular cone, we have the formula, curved surface area is pi r l. So, curved surface area, this is what is exactly given. So, out of 550, if you deduct 1 meter which is wastage, CSA will be 550, pi is known, R is given, therefore we can calculate L. So, here what is not given is this height. Observe this height. This is not given. So, for that what we do is first we will calculate L. Using curved surface area we will calculate L. We have three relations. You see the second relation, L square is equal to R square plus H square. Now you will understand this. Using the given radius and curved surface area, calculate L. Using L and the given R, calculate H. When H is known and R is known, you can calculate the volume. So, in this order, you have to solve the problem. This is first, this is second and this is third in this particular problem. So here canvas area is 551 meter square. So therefore this is including wastage. Wastage given, answer wastage given is equal to 1 meter square. So therefore actual canvas area equals 551 minus 1 is equal to 550 meter square. So the canvas area is this tent canvas area is 550 meter square excluding wastage. So therefore it is nothing but, you can write like this, nothing but curved surface area of right circular cone. So we have formula. So therefore curved surface area is equal to pi rl. So curved surface area is 550 equals 22/7 in, or given is 7 into L. So here 7 and 7 cancels, L will be equal to 550 divided by 22. 550 divided by 22. So we will get L is equal to 25 meter. So we have calculated L. Now we have used this formula. Now calculate H. This is, you can take it as step 1 in this problem. Now we will move on to step 2. In step 2, what you should do is use, we have L square is equal to R square plus H square. Here we have calculated L, that is 25 square. L is 25, R is 7 meters. This is 7 square plus H square. So H square equals 25 square minus 7 square. So that equals 625 minus 49. 625 minus 49. So this becomes 576. H square equals, H square is equal to 576, or H is equal to root of 576. That equals 24. So we got the height. So this is equal to 24. Height is 24. So we got height. We have radius. Therefore we can calculate the volume. Now please note down this. I will erase the beginning portions. So we'll go to step 3. Now step 3 in this problem. See, volume, they asked for volume of tent V equals pi r square h by 3. So that is 1 by 3 into 22/7 into 7 square, R is 7, into H is 24. So this you simplify. So 1232 meter cube we will get. So this is actually, this is given in the textbook, so only I am helping you to understand it. Now exercise 13.7. So dear students, I will stop at this stage. I will take up the exercise problems in 13.7 in the next class. Thank you.